Hi, it's Vicky here and welcome to the fourth video of my week featuring Penny Black. Today I will be working with this cute little girl from this Penny Black stamp set, which is called Twinkle and Wish. I am stamping the girl with archival ink and I will be using my Prismacolor pencils to add the color. For my Prismacoloring technique, I don't do anything really difficult. I am just using two different shades of the same color and I am adding the darker color at the edges of her hat while the lighter color at the center. So that way I am creating my shadows. I am going to put on some music and let you see how I color the hat. By using the same coloring technique, I have colored the whole image and now I am using my scissors to cut out the little girl. I am also making sure that as I cut her out, I am leaving a small area at the bottom to be a snowbank. My little girl is ready. I am going to put it aside and I am going to be working on the background. For the background, I have a piece of white cardstock which I am going to color blue. So first of all, I am using my broken china distress ink and I am applying some color with my blending tool and then I am going to bring in just a little bit of peacock feathers. And as I am creating my background, just to let you all know that Penny Black is having a giveaway for my audience. So for a chance to win $25 shopping spree on their online store, make sure to visit their Facebook page, like it and also let them know that Vicky sent you. I have this gorgeous metal die by Penny Black that says Let It Snow, which is going to be the sentiment for my card today. So I am trying to decide where this is going to go and I want those letters to be just next to the little girl. So once I am happy with the placement, I am going to run it through my Sizzix machine and cut out the phrase. I am going for the inlay die cutting technique, which means that I am going to remove that cutout piece and I'm going to put another on its place. I am being very gentle as I separate those pieces just because this is a very delicate die and I want to make sure that I will not ruin anything. I also make sure that I don't lose all those tiny little pieces that separate from the die because I will be using them later on. And as always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below in the description area if you're watching on YouTube. And also you can find a full list of all the supplies on my blog. I will be using this snowflake from another Penny Black stamp set and I will be stamping it with Versamark ink all over my background. When you are using distress ink on your background, you need to make sure that it is totally dry before you go ahead and start doing your embossing technique. Because distress ink does take a little time to dry, you might be able to see that I did had a little problems, but I did fix everything with just using a soft brush and brushing off any excess powder. So my background is now ready. I have already used my heat gun and set the powder and now all I have to do is use the die again and cut out the phrase out of white cardstock. And the idea now is to add that white phrase inside that hole. So to do so I need to have some backing and my backing needs to have adhesive. To do so I am using this adhesive tape and I am going to cover up just a scrap piece of paper which I am then going to peel off and stick at the back. So now, as you can see, the whole backing area is full of adhesive, and all I have to do now is to put the pieces back on. I have added the white phrase that says let it snow, and now I am going to use all those little blue pieces and stick them where they're supposed to be. It's such a quick and easy process because everything just pops in on its place. I really love the inlay die cutting because it gives a really pretty finish, and for all those people who are not card makers, when they receive such a card, they are really wondering how you made it. I have used foam tape at the back of the little girl to add a little bit of dimension. I am sticking her on top of my card. I will be using my scissors to cut out the excess paper. And my main panel is ready. Now for the finishing touches. I just have to add just a little bit of shimmer. And Ginger wants to say hello. So I am using my Wing of Stella glitter pen, and I will be adding some shine on some areas, such as the bird, her coat, and her boots. For my card base, I have used white cardstock. It's a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I am using my tape adhesive at the back of my panel. The panel is slightly smaller than the standard card, and that leaves a nice border, a white border, all around. I really like to have borders on my cards because I think it adds a nice finishing touch. Finally, I am adding some pearls at the center of the snowflakes, which are adding a touch of elegance. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me a thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Here are some close-up photos of the card. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to hit the subscribe button, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. And if you need more inspiration, here are more videos where I have used Penny Black supplies. You can click on any of the videos to watch it, or if you are watching from a mobile device, you can find links to all those videos just below in the description area, or you can click the info button that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching!